week one, guys, of Delta Galaxy Guard. Like we talked about on Tuesday, Delta Galaxy Guard is taking weaknesses out of Delta Hiva. So let's just talk about Delta Hiva first. So Carr's playing with a Delta Hiva hook, probably an angle grip, possibly controlling my posture with this grip. And then this leg is distance control. And we played a lot of this from when we were playing Delta Hiva X, about the Kazushi and the off balance. There's really three things, the weakness is to swim in the Delta Hiva guard. So probably from my perspective, obviously the first thing I'm looking to do is break this. So now he's controlling my posture, if that makes sense. Again, I could be kicking my leg this way, and maybe break that grip, possibly stopping this. Once I kick the leg, I'm in the headquarters. Options to cut cross, options to side smash position. And it'll become a constant battle when you're playing Delta Hiva guard. For Carr to lose control of this primary leg with his Delta Hiva hook and constantly be stuffing this leg. So let's take a look at how we can transition to Delta Galaxy and kind of close down those weaknesses in the guard and then use them to really control the person. So let's just say, Delta Hiva, collar, angle, again, the off balance is there. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the hand was in the collar to open up the lapel. Now I'm going to push on the car's rear leg and pass the lapel underneath and make it grip from my right hand to my left hand. Now, I can keep the Delta Hiva hooked in, that's an option, or I can keep it out. The reason the Delta Hiva hook is so good is because it controls the rotation of Carl's knee. Carl wants to turn his knee out this way so he can side smash, or he wants to turn this way so he can cut cross. So the Delta Hiva hook controls that. I want Carl's knee facing me like this, if that makes sense. Once I bring the lapel around, Carl actually tries to rotate his knee now. It's very, very difficult because the lapel is controlling his knee position. Now my right hand comes up and grabs this. Let's talk about the stuffed leg. Carl will want to make grips here and push my leg inside. So what I'm not even thinking about is hiding this foot. I just take it and put it on the inside of his hip. Okay? So now when Carl tries to do any of those three things, now I can work the whole Kazushi.
Thing. Let's just say I'm here and I haven't made this foot safe.
he goes to stop it. That's what he wants. If I can get this leg back again by swimming my left leg to the inside, to now have inside control of that leg, and now I can make that hook, and then eventually bring it back to the hip, and then I'll bring it back to the outside again. I'm late with this foot, I want to bring it in here, maybe Kara just stops it. So now from there, as he's cutting that corner, I can physically take my hook out to put it from the outside to the inside. I push it into the material here, that gives me a lot of control over Kara's movement. And now I can push, physically put my foot back into the hip again, and take it